Namaskar, I am B.Sivaramakrishn Rao, here before you to present my instrument, the sitar, its construction and some of the basic fundamentals of sitar playing. Now I am going to introduce you my disciple, Mr. Sri Ram Vijay Raghavan, who will support me in making this presentation. Sitar is one of the most popular melody instrument in Indian classical music today. Together with the surbahar and the tampura, it is a part of the family of long neck lutes. The sitar is played by sitting in a half lotus posture, like this. The lower part of the sitar is rested on the sole of the foot and it is held in an inclined position of about 45 degrees. There has to be sufficient gap between sitar and the player's chest. Not so close like this, but not so far like this. We have to handle like this. The thumb of the right hand is held firmly on the side of the sitar. It is never removed from there while playing. Playing strings are pulled with left hand. And are plucked with the right hand, index finger, by wearing this misra. This is called misrab. Misrab should be worn as tight as possible, wearing it loose, like this. Will be difficult to play. Also, it should not be pushed in too much, or should not protrude out too much. It should be worn. There is the position. First thing to be known is when we pluck the main string or bud string, the forward stroke is termed as da. This is da. The reverse stroke is termed as ra. This is da and ra. Da, ra. So this is the first basic lesson. Da, ra, da, ra. There are generally two types of sitar in terms of construction and tuning. One is called Karaj Panjam, which I am playing, and the other one is called Gandhar Panjam, which Sriram is having. Karaj Panjam is termed as Pandit Ravishankar's style of sitar. Gandhar Panjam is also referred to as Vilayat Khan's style of sitar. In Karaj Panjam, there are seven main playing strings. And 13 sympathetic strings. In Gandhar Panjam, there are 6 main playing strings and 11 sympathetic strings. This gourd is called tumba. It is present in Karaj Pancham style and it is absent in Gandhar Pancham style. Other than this, both the instruments are the same. We shall now try to understand the main parts of the sitar and its construction. Tapkandi. The tapkandi, also known as the tabli, is the faceplate. It is extremely important in determining the tone of the instrument. The next part we are going to see is kaddu. The kaddu is the resonator. This is nothing but a gourd. These are extremely delicate and must be protected against shock at all times. The next part of the sitar we are going to see is bada gorach, main bridge. The bada gorach, also known as jhavara or jhavari, is similar in construction to the chota gorach. This is used for the playing strings and the drawn strings. It is raised to allow the sympathetic strings to pass beneath. The next part we are going to see is chota gorach. The chota gorach, also known as the taraf ka gorach or jhavari, it is a small flat bridge for the sympathetic strings. Gullu. The gullu is a wooden cowl that connects the neck to the resonator. Dandi. This is the neck of the sitar, which has long neck lute with 20 curved metal frets. Parda. These are the frets. These are metal rods which are bent and tied to the neck with fishing line. A tar is a string. There are a number of strings on the sitar. Bajtar, which literally means the playing string. Virtually all of the playing is done on this one string. Chikari. There are a number of strings on the sitar which are played by plucking but not fretted. These are referred to as chikari or drawn strings. Tarafdar. The tarafdar are the sympathetic strings. They are almost never strummed, yet they vibrate whenever the corresponding note is played on the playing string. They are located underneath the frets, so fretting them to produce a melody is impossible. Kunti. The kuntis are the tuning pegs. These are simple friction pegs. The sitar has two types. There are the larger kuntis that are the main strings. There are also the smaller kuntis which are used for the sympathetic strings. Bajtar ki kunti. One of the most important kunti is the bajtar ki kunti. This is the one used for the main playing string. This one will be used more than any other. Tumba. Many sitars have a gourd which is attached to the neck. This is known as tumba. Not all sitars have a tumba. Up to now, we have seen the parts of the sitar.